Dear students, this is our second module on paragraph group. So these were the options or functionalities which we have not tried in paragraph group in the last module. So today we will be focusing on bullet library, how to add new bullets, numbering and indentation. So let's start. So let's have a blank document and let's write this is ITP course. Welcome to Virtual University. So in paragraph group, these are the options which we have not tried. The bullets, numberings, and then multi-level list, increase and decrease, indent. So let's try to focus on the bullets. So for example, we want to make this information in a bullet form in our document. So you can select any available bullet which is available over here. So like for example, if you select this one, so you can see that there is a tick in front of each of the writer. So if I press enter over here, so you can see that the tick bullet is available for me to start writing the next sentence. So I say hello world. So I can also change the bullets from this list. This is the bullet library. So for example, if I say this one, so you can see the bullets have changed. I can also use the numbering library. So for example, I can use this kind of numbering, this kind of numbering, whatever I want. Here is another important concept, that is decrease and increase indent. Indent means that if I want to make welcome to Virtual University as a subheading of this is ITP course, so I will select this one. I will click on increase indent. So this has been increased and this has become the subheading of this is ITP course. And I can of course change its bullet whatever I want. Similarly, as I have done previously, I can also select some of the numbering from here. So this means that this one is the main heading and this one is the subheading. So normally we do not use the same numbering if the main heading has also the bullet as numbering and subheading has also bullet of numbering. So it will be confusing. So let's select something from here. So if I press enter over here, so this will be on the same level that this is going to become another heading, which is a subheading of this is ITP course. So for example, if I write something here, welcome, so that welcome will become subheading. But suppose I want to make this at the same level as we have here. So I will put my cursor over here and I will say decrease indent. So this welcome has been shifted at the level of this one. And then you know that we have learned that this, if we want this 1, 2, 3 as the same in the continuous fashion, then we can select over here, select on the format painter, and I have clicked over here. So the format painter has make all of this as of the same way. So there could be some other ways to achieve the same thing. So we can use the bullet library, we can use the numbering library, and similarly, we can use multi-level heading. So one heading and inside there is another heading and another heading as well. And we have learned about decrease and increase indentation. And there is another important concept that if you are bored of using all of these bullet library, you can define your own bullet. So for example, if you click over here and say define new bullet, so it will give you two options, whether you want to insert some symbol or some picture. So let's try some symbol. So for example, this is a submission symbol. If I select it over here, okay, okay. So you can see that 1, 2, 3 has been shifted with submission symbol. So this submission has been added in the bullet library. And I can, of course, remove it by right clicking on this option. And similarly, I can also select some picture as well. You can go online or you can work offline. So if I go offline, for example, and I see that I want to, for example, put this as a picture. So now you can see that this is being shown. This is very dilute, so let's change it. You might not be able to see it. So let's put something bright. So now you can see it. So I have added this, and this have been added in the bullet library. So dear students, we have learned some of the remaining options in paragraph group. And we have talked about bullet library, number library. We have added some new things into the bullet library. And we have learned with the concept of indentation that how we can make some content as a subheading within the Microsoft Word and of the parent heading level. So we have experimented number of things in the paragraph group. So now our paragraph group is completed, and from next module we will move forward on the home ribbon button.